Today we're going to show you this immersion heater. This is a liquid fuel fire. This is a piece of military equipment. You can identify that this was manufactured in 1981 and it was just recently purchased on eBay. I think it was like $100, $110 shipping. Woo, 60 bucks. So anyways, I'm going to kind of open it up and show you what this is, and we're going to kind of light it up and do some stuff and kind of learn and have some fun. We're going to move the camera around. I kind of opened the crate just to see what it looked like, but I'm going to open it again for you. Okay, so let's go ahead and open it. I kind of closed the back up. It was nailed shut too. Oh, whoops. I'm going to have to turn it around so y'all can see it. Okay, so what do we have here? We have these two tubes. Here's one tube and another tube. And there's this donut down here. And I'm going to have to figure out a way to get this out so I can lift it out, because there's a block of wood holding it in here and a block of wood holding it in here. Let me show you the other two things it came with. This is the fuel tank here. I guess it's like a drip valve, maybe a fill. I don't really know. I haven't seen any instructions in here. And it's got some information on it there. And the other thing that came in the box, I think these are extended flue pipes. Right here. So the story is, my dad wanted one of these because in Vietnam, when he worked, when he was in the military, they used these in Vietnam, and he was like, what are these things? And so as I get this out, I'm going to kind of tell you dad's story, Vietnam story, what these are and how they were used when he recognized them. So I kind of opened the crate up so I can put this piece of wood back. Now I'm able to lift the whole unit up, and there it is, and I'll set it on the ground here. So there's this immersion heater. These are the strappings. I'm going to pull the strappings off. And there's some instructions here. This is the pipe. Wow. So the way that this works, I mean, far be it for me to tell you how it works, but the donut at the bottom is welded, and you can see the weld line here. So apparently the flame comes down onto this side, goes in a circle around here, and then this is your exhaust pipe here. And then what you do, because I think this is designed for heating water, I think they would typically use a trash can. I just have this tub here, that they would put this in some water, light it up to create hot water. And we're actually going to do that. We're going to fill this tub up with water. We're going to take the gas tank, get it loaded. We're actually going to heat water with this thing.
To start heater, number one, secure the heater. Erect four sections of smoke pipe.
It wants an erect heater?
That's what it said. Why does it use the word erect?
I don't know what
they
that
know
means.
There's a bunch of horny boys like fighting for their life, scared to death in Vietnam, and they use the word erect. Anyways, erect four sections of smoke pipe.
So you
smoke pipe again too.
Smoke pipe. Erect and smoke pipe.
Man, okay. Those poor men. Okay. Fill the fuel tank and mount in position.
Mount it.
Wow, this guy was like totally horny when he wrote
these
porno
references in the first.
Let's just
sentence.
Read that again. Secure your heater and erect four sections of smoke pipe. Then fill the fuel tank and mount in position.
Mount it in position. Oh my god.
This is so dirty. Okay. Oh god. Unscrew the vent plug at the top of the fuel tank and swing lighter cup below
swing
drip
it around.
Valve.
You wanted to swing
below
it?
The drip valve.
Okay.
Oh man, am I horny? Because I'm starting to be concerned that I am just like my mic's in the
maybe
gutter.
Maybe it's just urine.
I don't know. Okay. So let me. I'm sorry, guys.
Okay, go.
Unscrew
on,
the
hey,
vent
this
plug.
This video. Be cool.
Come on, man. Be cool. Number three. Open the drip valve until the lighter cup is a quarter full of gasoline. Ignite the fuel in the lighter cup and return cup for preheating of fuel. I'm not understanding all this.
It's clear as mud to me, so... I think you just dump gasoline in it and light it. That's what
but
I think.
But only a quarter full, I guess? I don't know. After 1 minute, swing burner cup so that the edge is below the drip valve. Open the drip valve and stream will ignite from the burner cup. Oh my God, that I hope not. I just had like the worst visual on that
stream,
one.
You just woo! Got a stream, right?
Which is ignited. Which is even scary.
Ignited stream, okay.
Where was I? Okay, number 7. Swing glider back to flue.
Swing back.
Number 8, adjust fuel level to just below the smoke point. And number 9, close the hood assembly after starting.
Okay, very good instruction readings.
I'm going to have to read this 4 more times before I fully grasp it.
So Dad was telling me the story about these. He said that they were like lighted with toilet paper or something. So, and that was back in Vietnam, which is 70 or something or other like that. This one's got a lighter cup, so it's a little different. We're trying to work our way through the instructions. But we do notice there's a piece of paper down in there. And Heather, if you can stick your hand down there and grab that piece of paper out. I either suspect that that's a piece of paper or a piece of paper with something wrapped in it.
I dropped them both.
Are you going to have to reach down farther now?
There's one piece of something.
Did you get the rest?
Not yet. I was showing it off here.
Okay. All right. We'll get the rest.
I'm trying to show off my pieces.
All right. Okay.
Oh, this is definitely a cup of some sort.
Okay. Why don't you open that up for the camera?
Okay.
I'm going to open this one off screen.
Well, how fun is that for anybody?
Okay. Oh.
This is a valve of some sort?
That's the drip valve.
Okay.
Okay. Now go ahead and open this.
Here.
Okay. That's the burner plate.
Does it go on this side?
I think it does. We might have, yeah, I think the fuel drips on this plate.
You stick this in here, mm-hmm. And the fuel, oops.
I don't think it's supposed to go that far.
No, actually it does. I think it does. Okay, so go ahead and show down there.
I'm showing as good as I can.
So the plate goes all the way down there in the bottom and the fuel drips on that plate and I think that's where it burns.
Okay, and there's the burner cup and there's the fuel plate.
Okay.
Cool, we found some instructions. I think they got a web URL. They should just go there. Holy cow! Whoa!
I think the technical manual can be found from the Department of Army Publication Center.
What's really fantastic about this?
Yes.
Is that if you look at this, guess where this came from?
This is from St. Louis. That's where we live.
This is where we live, in St. Louis, Missouri.
Cool.
So this is where it came from originally. Okay, so we've got to do some more figuring things out. Fingering things out. And then we'll be back. So when the fuel drips down, it drips on this plate, and this is where we're trying to get it lit. So we're going to go ahead and install this with this plate so it can the flame can go in the circle. So I'm going to go ahead and install that. Hold on.
That's a flashlight. Okay. Can you grab the flashlight and show in there so I can see
sure.
it?
Sure. Okay.
So there's the plate there.
Okay.
Okay. So... And we're going to come over here and we're going to take a look at the pipes. These are the extension pipes.
And it's got that good military tape on there.
I can't really get over there. I'm kind of stuck.
Pause.
Okay, I'm going to pause it.
Go. All right, so we're opening this box up. And there's pipes in here, I'm guessing.
Now, so, Don, what do they use these water heaters for? I mean, they're water, water but for what?
For
showers
Dad,
or what?
Dad,
is it?
Explain the story, what they use these for. He said when he got into Vietnam and they were having mess, that he wanted to, he's seen these and they got out of the mess hall. They got the food and got out of the mess hall. They got done eating. They had a Steve, MREsteve. I'll put a link down here. They have these stainless steel trays with 5 compartments. And they put your tray into 5 compartments and they had some silverware. So you get done eating, and then they had 3 of these things running. One in
And Dad said that these were so you could wash your own tray. You rough washed it with just water in the first one. And then there was a second one with a lot of suds in it. And these were like 55-gallon fuel drums filled with water. So you'd pre-rinse it in the first one. The second one, you kind of wash it with soap. And then you'd rinse it on the third one. He said you'd stack it in a pile. And then that was for the next time that you were going to eat mess.
Huh.
So you'd wash your own dishes in Vietnam.
Wow.
So there does look to, there does appear to be four... four pipes in here that are, you assemble them yourself.
Wow. Oh,
and they do come with, there's a bag here with screws in it. I don't think we're going to go with all four sections. We're going to try one or two. Next thing we're going to do is kind of fill a fuel tank. And then we're going to take this outside, put some water in it, and give it a shot. Okay, well, we'll have to cut these few seconds out. But anyway, I want to take the time. We're getting ready to fill this up with water to start. But Dad, I want to personally thank you. He bought this for himself, and he asked me to order it and get it in. Here comes the water, guys. And Dad says, hey, you want to play with it? He says, go ahead, play with it. I'm going, really, Dad? This is your toy. And he's like, no. He's like, you go ahead and play with it. That's like the coolest thing. Like, I don't know, if I got a toy, like, I just want it to be my toy, right? But Dad's like, no, go ahead, do it. So here I get to relive the same experience kind of Dad did when he was in Vietnam. Dad, did they have these problems in Vietnam?
It's floating, how are we gonna stop that?
What are we supposed to do now, Dad? This wasn't in the manual.
Are you supposed to put a brick on it? What do you do? Shit, we can't light it on fire with it acting all crazy.
It's gonna be like a torpedo.
Yeah, that's not good.
Who knows that? Oh. That's why it's got the locking thing. We're gonna have to find something to hold that in place.
Here.
Oh. There you go. Here, put that in there. Dad said put bricks under it. I'm gonna say put bricks on top of it. Whoa! Good job! Woo. Now, can we fill it a little more?
Oh, you want
to? I want to put more water. I want to fill it up to the top. I'll tell everyone to stop. Come on, we're gonna fill it up to the top. Okay, stop. Good job, Heather.
You're welcome. All right, push pause.
You want me to do that? I don't want them to see me struggling with this.
Do you need your drill?
No, I don't.
They're already watching you, man.
Oh, are they?
Okay. Yeah. Too late.
I don't know if we're going to do all these stacks. Oh, maybe you need to do them all. I don't know.
Why are all your screwdrivers really huge?
We're not putting screws in it.
We're not?
No, that's just okay. For chickens. And...
Oh, yeah, sure. Flaming thing. Let's just let it boing open.
Okay, so we got one stack.
Why is it that men never need to take any safety precautions?
Okay, here's the drip valve. And apparently there was no Teflon tape. No. I mean, yeah, probably because it's dangerous if you don't, but...
Yeah, well, I guess just diesel doesn't light that flame though, right? So, like, it won't go back up in?
You got me, I don't know.
Oh, jeez.
Anyway, are we using...
Aren't you the pyro of our family?
What are we using? Are we using gasoline?
No.
Dad said I can't use gasoline because he didn't want me to blow myself up.
Thank you, Dad.
He said use diesel fuel or kerosene.
Yeah.
And I don't have...
Kerosene. It's too expensive. Diesel's the same, right?
It's the exact same thing.
Only different.
All right. And we're not going to, like, fill this all the way up.
Do you have the... Okay. Is that little thingy open so that way it doesn't backwash? Never mind.
The top of it looks like a funnel anyway.
Uh-huh. I guess it kind of is. They didn't want to make it so that the guys would spill the stuff everywhere.
Okay.
The beer. It's beer. Did you know that?
The beer.
It's beer. They didn't
I think of Forrest Gump. Forrest Gump, when they got it, it's like, get yourself a beer and we got steaks cooking. Uh-huh. You know, Dad tells a story like it was all misery, and then I watched Forrest Gump. I was like, they were drinking beer and... smoking cigarettes and eating T-bones. What's the truth?
You know
it's got to be somewhere in the middle.
I honestly hope that they were giving him beer and T-bones and cigarettes. Somebody's shooting at me all day long. I mean, Are we out of diesel? Oh my gosh.
Well, I'll wipe it up. And you know what's really cool about diesel fuel is it discourages rust.
Does it?
Yeah.
I did not know that.
So I'll put that cap on and I'll clean up that diesel fuel.
Okay.
All right. And then we're going to head on over and light up. All right. So we got a little bit of diesel fuel in the tank. We're going to go ahead and install it. There's that piece of steel there. And this just comes and sits right on that piece of steel. There we go.
Oh, jeez.
I think we need another brick.
Yeah, okay.
Hold on. Okay, so we're going to open the vent. This lets air into the top of the tank. Mm-hmm. Hopefully we've got enough diesel fuel in here. And then there's this little cup that we bring over here. Does it lock?
You have to hold it.
Okay. Yeah. And so we open this valve and let this soak with diesel fuel.
See if I can get a zoom on it a little bit.
Okay, there we go. Now we get some out of there. And what, like a quarter full?
Yeah, that's what it said, quarter full.
Okay. So we got a fuel. Now what does the disruption
say? It says
say?
Wait for a minute.
Okay, so we're going to let that soak. We'll be back with you in just a minute. So we've let that soak for a while, and we're going to bring it over here, and we're going to light it. Got a little bit of wind here, guys.
I don't know. Okay, there it goes. Put it in the hole.
There we go. So now the draft is coming up here. I feel a little heat, a little warm.
I see smoke too. Want to see it?
Yeah.
Want to see it, YouTube?
Smoke coming out there.
Okay, we got smoke.
I see the flame coming up.
Good. Now we let it heat up the thingy for a minute, is what the instructions say.
So the air will go down this way through the donut and back up. And we may need to add another stack section. I don't really know. I feel the heat.
You think it's warm?
Yeah.
And then we make the drip happen. And then
now,
we cover.
Or
after it's hot, it's after this warms up, it says make the drip happen.
Okay. Well, it's heating up then.
Okay. My silly camera keeps moving. Sorry, YouTube. Donnie, fix that.
Yeah. This is a really cold and hard to burn diesel fuel, but okay, we're supposed to let it drip real slow, so I'm going to start a slow drip. There you go. We're supposed to get that flame to go down.
Can't we just light it with the torch?
Yeah, we could.
Okay, but that wouldn't be the same.
Yeah, because it's going to be hard because that kerosene's getting cold down there. If you use gasoline, it would just drop straight down in there.
Stop it. Not using gasoline. So it's kerosene.
I think I have a trick, though, that may work.
What's that? Light something on fire to shove it down in there?
All right, pause it. Okay, we started to get a flame. It took a second.
And now we're supposed to cover it back up, right? Didn't it say?
Oh, the flame
it?
Went down. Okay. Now we need to open the kerosene valve.
More. Okay.
Come on, baby. There we go. Okay, now we got a flame.
We do?
Yeah, we got it. Can you look down in there?
Yeah, I'm trying. Can you get me the?
Can I get you the what?
There it is. Okay, anyway. Sorry.
So we got the flame down there.
Okay.
And it's burning, and you can see the smoke coming up here.
Is the drip good, or do we need less drip?
Well, I don't know. Yeah, we could try less.
It's a pretty constant flow.
Okay. Well, let's turn it down a little bit. This gets hot. It's not even dripping. It's kind of streaming.
Yeah, just go for more of a drip.
Man, this would be violent if it was gasoline.
Yeah, there's a drip.
Okay, now we got a drip. Can you see down in there?
Yeah.
Okay, so what we see is, we see the plate down there. I don't know if you guys can see the drip, but the flame is down there.
Okay.
And dripping the diesel fuel there, and it's staying on fire as it's dripping. And then what we got here, we got the heat coming out of the stack, and it's pretty warm here. I mean, I can keep my hands there for a second.
It's a lot of smoke.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So it said just to cover the top, though, didn't it?
Oh, yeah. The next thing it said was to do this.
Okay.
So we're going to let this run at a drip for a little bit, and we'll get a temperature gauge and measure the water temperature.
Okay.
Okay, so we just got it going right now, and we're going to take a test of the water temp. And 50, 60 degrees.
You're not going to put it in front of the camera?
I'll do that.
Oh, you can't
I don't know if it'll focus.
You can't see it.
You got to believe me, guys. It's like 60 degrees.
Okay.
So we're going to let this run for a little bit, and then we'll come back and show you what happens. Okay, guys, we've been running for about 10 minutes now. And we're going to check the water temperature here. And I know you can't see it. Depending on where I look, 65 degrees right now. And I'm going to turn the flame up a little bit because I think I'm running a little bit slow. Okay, guys, I'm going to put another 2-foot section on top to see if I get a little bit more draw. So there we go. Another 2-foot section of pipe. There we go. And let's check the water temp right now. Oops, let's come back, get a little bit closer here. So this has been running for maybe 20 minutes now. And the water temperature is up to, hold on, depending on where you look, I got 89 to 93. So 20 minutes, it's raised it from what, 60 to 90 degrees. Okay, so we'll keep an eye on it. I mean, I think boiling's where I want to be. I think that's what I'm going to show. Okay, I want to show you down the throat right there. I don't know if you can kind of see the drip in there. Pretty steady stream there. It's getting hot, boiling. There's the throat right there. It's really starting to glow and get hot. I can feel the exhaust pipe getting hot. And guess what? I'm also seeing some pretty interesting activity here around the water, and I want to show you that here. You know, it probably gets different levels of hot in different places, but it seems like I'm seeing boiling right around this. Here, let me move the light so you can kind of see it. I'm seeing bubbles come up underneath these bricks. So definitely some of this water is up to boiling. Right there, you can see. We're gonna get this whole thing boiling and then we're gonna call that done. And maybe this is hotter than normal, but this is what I think people wanna see, is stuff boiling. Maybe right off the top, oh, let me move over here. I don't know if you can see that streaming down in there, right there. Just streaming that fuel down in there. Yeah, we're not gonna run this much hotter than that. Here's the exhaust pipe, and I saw it, sorry, it's not real bright. But over here, you can see steam running there. Put my hands in there, woo, it's a little bit warm, you won't put your hands in there. And maybe it's been about 25 minutes now. A pretty slick system, it seems to be holding up pretty well. Close the air vent like the instructions say. All right, like I said, we'll get this up to full boiling and I think we'll call that done. All right, I don't know, maybe it's 30 minutes or whatever. I'm gonna check the water temperature now. 150 right there. 151 over here. 143. So we keep raising. I mean, you see it down there by the metal, it's boiling. So just wanted to go ahead and show you down the Dragon's Throat again. Anyway, Dad, I really appreciate how we've been talking and getting along the past couple weeks. Definitely hope we can keep that up. We'd really love to go do a field trip at your place again and show some of the cool stuff you got. And you let me show this off, which is really cool. And this is awesome, man. If you need to cook soup or wash dishes or take a bath, this is the thing to do it with. So we're getting close to where we need to be. I mean, I see, you look at that water, you can see it's going. Not supposed to get it too hot, though, because I don't want to melt everything. Like I said, 212, boiling, get that whole sucker going. That'd be the coolest thing, like right out here in the middle of the open, boiling water. Okay, we're starting to get a lot of boiling action. Although the temperature sensor is only saying 170, 180. That's about a rolling boil right there, guys. Anyways, so now I gotta follow the shutdown instructions. If anybody remembers what they are, if you could tell me, I'd like to know. So what I discovered, guys, is actually I was being a chicken and I didn't feed this thing enough fuel. They would probably boil water in 10 to 15 minutes if you gave it enough fuel. But that's definitely a rolling boil right there. The whole pot. That's pretty cool stuff.
Dad, I can't thank you enough for letting me play with this toy. And I can't wait to see the fun that you have with it. I'm going to go ahead and shut her down. Let's stop the fuel drip. There. And put the safety cap on. A lot of fun. A lot of interesting stuff. Thank you for letting me share a little bit of Vietnam with you. I really appreciate it. Okay, YouTube, I want you all to have a nice evening. And sorry if the video was a little too long, but thank you very much for watching. And I'd appreciate thumbs up, comments, anything you got to say. Have a good evening.